When was the last time, Mike, you were actually at a barber?
We're gonna go with 16 years.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm sure you can tell by the lines, I've done this myself for 16 years.
So it's the end of November, and Mike has gallantly, valiantly, has been growing his beard to raise awareness for men's health issues, for men's mental health issues, and for prostate issues. All those things that men never talk about. So how's it going, Mike? You're a month into this.
I'm actually liking it. It's an investment, though. It really is.
Yeah.
So I'm ready to have something done with it. It's a little burly. It's just there. I like to look nice. I like to try to look nice.
Mm-hmm.
So we came here to buddies at Cut Throat Barbershop in Scottsdale, Arizona, and we're going to check this thing out. Here's the cool part about Cut Throat. We're going to have a couple of beers, and then we're going to go figure out what we're going to do with this. I got the pros taking care of us today.
So let's see if they have pro craft beers, local-based beers on tap. That's step number one.
Now, we found out that they do have, although it does say Husk, which is local, they do have some Husk on tap. This is Dragoon out of Tucson on tap right here at a barbershop.
That's right.
And they have Chuck Norris on TV. It's like testosterone overload right
now. This is a man place. It's where men get the beards trimmed.
Yeah. I'm getting it all trimmed, by the way. It's all going.
Oh, you
lettuce,
all in.
Lettuce, everything is done, yeah.
Look at back and neck, all this nonsense.
Yeah, you gotta get that. You gotta get that out. But here's gonna be the question, because there's different types of manliness now in beards. So beards can be a little metro, beards can be a little outdoorsy.
There will be no metro. Here's the deal, I don't want to look like I'm looking for a hook. How about that? I just want this beard cleaned up. That's it. Look like a man should look.
Well, I'll drink to that. Good luck, brother.
Thanks. I'm going in. So here he is, and here this is. This is the post-cut, post-trim, the new me. My man Raven here. Raven, what did we do, man? You saw a man come in here all weird lettuce and Neanderthal kind of look. What'd you do?
So what we did, I did a nice little taper in the back, did a zero, took it up to a one up here, didn't want it so short, blended it in, avoided the scar action, and then lined up the beard, blended it in, and trimmed the top with some scissors. And that's basically
it. He did the scissors on the top, no lawnmower kind of action right there. You see, and we go on the website here, and we check this place out, this man's tattoo, give me all I needed to know. Pick that one.
So this is Eric Ayala. He is the owner of Cut Throat Barbershop here in Scottsdale. So Eric, you've been doing this for how long? When did you open?
2014, my man.
2014, so that's, do the math. I think, Mike, that's 4 years.
Yeah.
And I want to ask Mike this. How'd you find out about this place?
I just went online. I looked at good reviews. I hadn't really gone through this kind of process before, but I haven't cut, that haven't been to a barber in 16 years.
Almost 2 decades. You got him to come out to 2 decades.
2 decades, you crazy, man? I didn't know that. What the heck?
I came here to spoil the hell out of myself, and here we are.
Did.
It is fantastic. What a great place you got here, man.
Thank you, brother.
So now, anyone can have a cut hair, so I opened up the shop. What made you go with the whole concept? You got a bar here, it's a man shop, let's be real.
Yeah, man, it's just kind of, first it was a place for just a barber shop, and then we started growing, our staff started growing, and then just kind of pushed us to kind of more what else, how we exceed the experience,
right?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
At beer, since
why
we had a bar district. Have to do.
When you cut out for the night, what do you drink? What do you hit off the taps over there?
Dude, right now, I've been on the two-hearted,
Yeah.
I've been on the two-hearted.
Nice. Yes.
By the way, that was just rated by the American Homebrewers Association best beer in America.
Yeah, I heard. I heard. Yeah.
See,
I heard.
He knows his beer, knows his beards, knows his hair.
Yeah, feels right. Like a baby's ass.
You want to feel your neck,
feel it. Feel it. You gotta feel that. No, Raven did this. Go ahead. Let's go.
Who's Raven?
Raven's my barber.
Just kidding.
Come on now, Travis. Come on, feel it. Feel it.
I don't think I've ever smooth felt a man's a neck before.
Ass. Look at that. Go.
Ooh.
Yeah. You're welcome. You're welcome. Yeah.
You're buying beer.
No. You're buying me beer.
You just felt me up, man.
That's why you're buying me
charge,
beer.
There's a charge for that.
Okay, fine. It felt good. Beer's on me. But that proves it. That's how tight the shave is. That's what you want. So here's the interesting thing about this.
I won't have to shave for days.
No, you will. Definitely won't.
With that hot towel, the razor, the straight edge razor, I'm not going to shave for days.
So here's the thing that's interesting to me. So you take me outdoors, you're taking me hunting with a shotgun in my hand,
yeah.
Outdoorsing me up.
Yeah.
So here you are, first time in 16 years you were in a barbershop doing right. What Rob does, getting the beard trimmed, getting the hair looking nice, getting the fade.
Yeah.
So we're like,
I'm all about this. I mean, once I roll in, they got beer, they got Chuck Norris on the TV. I'm like, I feel just right with this. Nice hot towel, straight razor.
Yeah.
I'm in. This is awesome.
Look at him. He's like redefining it. Handsome.
Well, I'm trying to.
Handsome he looks.
Yeah, I don't look like a pumpkin anymore.
No, you. Well, I wouldn't say you look like a pumpkin. Now, like, now that I touched your neck, I'm like. Yeah, I would. It's getting hot here. What are you drinking?
The shoot's fresh squeezed. If you fresh squeeze me, I'm gonna knock you out.
I already did.
I will knock you out.
I already did. Yeah.
No, kind of fresh squeeze.
I got a shout out to Huss, so I had a little sips while Mike was getting his neck did.
Scottsdale Blonde.
Scottsdale Blonde, yeah, exactly.
Cut Throat Barbershop, get down here to Scottsdale. These guys, this is a fun place to hang out. They're great people, they're welcoming. You know, even to rednecks like me, they bring me in. We're gonna make you right, yeah.
Alright. Cheers, y'all. What was it just like, we gotta add beer to this?
I think the demand, you know, the demand, the people were asking for beer.
Yep.
Give the people beer.
Let's give the people beer.
So, you know, baseball players have like walkout music. What's your best cut music? Your haircut?
Good question.
Music?
It's just more like, you know, lo-fi, hip-hop, the jazzy, just can kind of set the tone, you know what I mean? You're in a good rhythm. You know, lo-fi, blood vibes,
so we heard some Souls of Mischief, 93 Till Infinity. We heard So Fresh and So Clean, some Outkast. We got some Wu-Tang on in the background. We heard some Nas and Rolls Royce produced by my man Pete Rock. That's the kind of vibe we're going with.
Yeah.
What he said.
Mine, I sip the dumb pee, watching Gandhi till I'm charged and writing in my book around.